There is no secret, the Wu-Tang Clan is a highly respected hip-hop group, with rappers known for the gritty sound, impressive flow and vivid storytelling, with each member known for their own style. And one member is specifically known for his crazy flow, complex lyricism and iconic verses. And it goes by the name of the Inspectah Deck. This video will take a look back at Deck's humble beginnings, along with taking a look at the height of his career. This is a story about the first one to set it off, the Inspectah Deck. Jason Hunter, also known as Inspectah Deck, was born 1970 in Brooklyn, New York, and later moved to Park Hill, Staten Island, where he went to school with future Wu-Tang members Ghostface Killah, Method Man, and Raekwon. However, it would take a while for Inspectah Deck to take up an interest in rapping, and as a matter of fact, his passion for hip-hop began in jail due to other prisoners rap battling. And one day, Inspectah Deck decided to join in, which led him to take up the pen and start writing. Furthermore, after his release from jail, his passion for hip-hop would lead him to start recording tapes at RZA's crib, together with future Wu-Tang members like Method Man, U-God, and Raekwon. RZA had already tried his luck in the music business as a solo artist under the name Prince Rakim. Having said that, he wasn't met with great success, and he knew he had to go about it in a different way. And the way was to create a group that no one could ever have imagined. A group called the Wu-Tang Clan. And to set up the group, RZA decided to recruit the best rappers he knew. And together, they were the RZA, the Jizza, the Older the Bastard, Inspectah Deck, Raekwon the Chef, U-God, Ghostface Killah, and the Method Man. He told the crew to give him 5 years, and it would take them to number one. Immediately, they started working. And in October of 1992, they recorded their first single, and Inspectah Deck was the first one to set it off. Smoke all the mic like smoking Joe Frazier, the Hellraiser, raising hell with the flavor. Terrorize the jam like troops in Pakistan, swinging through your town like your neighborhood Spider-Man. Due to the success of the record, they were able to enter the music business for real. And in 1993, they released their first album under the Wu-Tang 36 Chambers, with Inspectah Deck being the second most featured artist on the album, as well as getting a verse on Wu-Tang's most famous song ever, Cream. Together, they brought something unique to the world that had never been seen before. Their sound, lyrics, styles of rhyming were different, along with their martial arts approach to hip-hop. Following the album entered Wu-Tang 36 Chambers, the group members started to build their solo careers, due to RZA's main objective to launch each member as a solo star by giving exposure through the Wu-Tang Clan. It all began for Inspectah Deck when he made guest appearances on Method Man's Decal, Raekwon's Only Built for Cuban Links, Jizza's Liquid Swords, and Ghostface Killah's Iron Man. Not to mention, he also made a short appearance on the record Got My Mind Made Up, before being cut out from the song by Tupac himself.
Inspectah Deck is on the original.
At the end it says INS the Rebel, and then cuts
INS
off.
INS the Rebel.
Yeah.
Turn my states to pebble. Mental terrorist, specialists at this. Menacing lyricist leaves crews defenseless.
Why y'all cut him off the record?
Oh man, Tupac.
I get it. I understand.
Beat is over. Okay? Just take him off.
Damn it.
Wait,
man.
But it sounds tight, Pac. I mean, I don't want to hear all that tight stuff, man. Take that off.
So Daz kind of threw a little slickness on him and took him off, but he kept his background.
Yeah. Sis, since this.
Fucking Daz was like, man, we're going to keep some of this stuff.
Wow. It was tight, man. Give it up for Inspectah
Deck.
You know what I'm saying? Pac didn't hear it until the record was out. Mm-mm. He ain't noticed none of that at the end. So he didn't care. Mm-mm. He was just being mean.
However, the release date of Inspectah Deck's debut album, Uncontrolled Substance, would be much later, in the year of 1999. The album was originally scheduled to release in 1995 with Loud Records, but due to the infamous flood in RZA's studio, the debut album of Inspectah Deck was lost. According to the RZA, the album was as good as the rest of the solo classics in the Wu-Tang Clan. In an interview with The Breakfast Club, he stated, "Every member of Wu got a chance to be the best, I think. And at one point, he was the best. His sword was the sharpest. If we would have had the production and the vibe of what this album would have been, I'm sure he would have a classic in the ranks of Cuban Links and Liquid Swords." Nonetheless, the ball kept rolling and it was time for the Wu-Tang Clan to reunite. And in 1997, they released their second album, Wu-Tang Forever. Needless to say, the album became a success and it debuted at number one on the Billboard 200. And Inspectah Deck was the first one to set it off with one of the greatest verses in the history of hip-hop. After the release of the album, Inspectah Deck continued to work on his solo career, collaborating on projects with Big Pun, Pete Rock, Method Man, and most notably, Gangstar on their track Above the Clouds, which is one of Gangstar's most recognized track ever. Soon after, it was finally time for Inspectah Deck to release his first solo album, Uncontrolled Substance. However, due to the flood, the damage was beyond repair, and the album never became a classic, like earlier Wu-Tang solo projects had become. Due to lacking features from the more successful in the Wu-Tang Clan, as well as not being entirely produced in the Chamber Studio by the RZA, featuring more of Deck's own production. However, it wasn't an entire disaster, and in general, it received positive reviews, and it's Inspectah Deck's most critically acclaimed album to date. Since then, Inspectah Deck has released a great number of solo albums, as well as continuing to appear on the Wu-Tang projects. But the Wu-Tang Clan isn't the only group Inspectah Deck has been involved with. He's also playing a big role in no other group than Scarface, a hip-hop trio formed by Inspectah Deck and the underground duo 7L and Esoteric, releasing their first album with Brick Records in 2013. To put it briefly, it's based around the character Scarface, a hero whose mission is to save hip-hop. And since then, they've continued to release albums, even dropping two collaboration albums with MF Doom and one with Ghostface Killah. Even though Inspectah Deck has overcome many challenges throughout his career, he's without a doubt one of the most talented to ever touch the mic, with his crazy flow, complex lyricism, and iconic verses.
Like this, I'm gonna start from the top. Inspectah Deck, he's like that dude that'll sit back and watch you play yourself and all that, right? And see you sit there and know you lying, and he'll take you to court after that, because he the inspector. That's why he the, and also he the rebel lioness.